So this question that I wrote is based off of one that I saw on a 2CK NBME exam, one of the online forms. Now, of course, I've changed up the fucking question, okay? So no, it's not going to artificially inflate your score. Relax. And I know many of you are studying for step one. This is a 2CK level question, arguably, because we have nematocyl as a potential distractor here, okay? And this vignette is slightly unusual. If you're studying for step one, this would come off very nebulous. You say, not really sure like what to make of some of the descriptors here. So how about I start the fucking question? How's that sound, okay? And please subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate it. Give the video a thumbs up. So we have a 65-year-old woman. She's been on a ventilator for a couple weeks and sustaining head trauma. Serial chest x-rays showing ARDS. Bronchoalveolar lavage showing a mix of gram-positive cocci, gram-negative rods. Current chest x-ray shows a cavitary lesion in the right lower lobe, and then we simply have what's the diagnosis. So why don't we just go through the answer choices here. Choice A, acute bronchopulmonary aspergillosis, aka ABPA. Wrong fucking answer, okay? You will see this on a very rare occasion. This will essentially present similar to asthma in a patient where they say there is hypersensitivity to aspergillus antigen or there's aspergillus antigen detected. It'll be a very easy question if you get ABPA on USMLE. It's not a big deal, okay? You can just peripherally be aware of the diagnosis. Atelectasis, also the wrong fucking answer. You need to know that this is the most common cause of fever within 24 hours post-surgery. I have seen it within 2 days post-surgery on an obs-gyn question, a patient with a C-section. Common cause of fever post-surgery. You can also see that atelectasis means lung collapse, okay? So you can see areas of lung collapse in patients who have suppressed respiratory rate, e.g. if they're on opioids, for example. And they might say that there's nonspecific infiltrates bilaterally in the lower lobes. That's atelectasis, okay? Fever after surgery, high yield. Nematocyl, wrong fucking answer. Now, nematocyl, it's close. It's actually not too bad. Nematocyl is an air collection. It will present as a cavitary lesion, similar to in this stem, frequently in patients who have ARDS, okay? It's due to small tears in one of the airways. That's how I've read it in the literature, classically in ARDS. The only problem is that you will not have this finding of a polymicrobial lavage. You're not going to have that. So when we throw that into the mix, something that's a cavitary lesion in a patient with ARDS, which would ordinarily sound like nematocyl, but we're throwing in a polymicrobial bronchoalveolar lavage, that is pulmonary abscess, okay? The gram-positive cocci, peptostreptococcus, gram-negative rods, mobile lungus bacteroides, these are oropharyngeal normal flora. Patients with aspiration risk, head trauma, Parkinson's disease, alcoholism, epilepsy, dementia with Alzheimer's, you lose the gag reflex. So these patients can have aspiration. They might say something like patient has broken teeth. And you can get an air fluid level on chest x-ray, which we don't have here. That's what also makes it more challenging. An air fluid level is a cavitary lesion where the bottom half is white. That's your pus that settles due to gravity, and the upper half of the semicircle is black. That's your air fluid level, okay? That's your 9 out of 10 stems are going to have air fluid level for pulmonary abscess if they describe it on chest x-ray. Here, it sounds like pneumatocele, a cavitary lesion ARDS, but they tell you there's a polymicrobial aspirate, okay? So this is pulmonary abscess. Tuberculosis is wrong. You can get cavitary lesions, but the vignette just doesn't quite fit. The demographic, I mean, it's not to say you couldn't get it in an older woman, but they might say something like 40-year-old dude who's been in a homeless shelter for a while, an immigrant from an endemic area. USMLE likes Albania. They like rural India, okay? I've seen that, those locations on NBME exams. They might give you B symptoms, fever, night sweats, weight loss. So tuberculosis just doesn't fit here, okay? So this is pulmonary abscess. Treat with clindamycin, okay? So 50S ribosomal subunit inhibitor inhibits translation. We could make this an extended clip, but how about I just end the fucking clip, all right? You know the deal. I'm going to continue to make more content. If you like my stuff, subscribe to my channel, and I appreciate your time. That's it.